Hey everybody, it's been a minute. So I just realized that it's been 5 months since my last upload, and arguably 7 months since the last time I uploaded an actual high effort video. And for that, I just wanted to say I'm sorry, but I think you guys deserve to know what happened in between now and then. I just realized I've never said it on my channel. I've always said it on pixelart.com and other websites I use for my socials, but I think you guys on YouTube deserve to know what's going on. So basically, around summer of this year, when I just graduated from high school, I ended up having a severe depressive episode. We tried all kinds of medications and whatnot, and for lack of better terms, it felt like my brain was rotting out of my skull. So, for a while, I just couldn't bring myself to do content, or much of anything for that matter, if I'm being honest. But yeah, I don't want to blame my mental health for absolutely every one of my YouTube mistakes. I will admit that a large part of the reason why this channel's kind of dying off is because of my own laziness. I can't really deflect that. That's just an objective truth. And I'm really sorry about that. I'm gonna work harder on making better content for you guys, and I'm gonna try to do more streaming and whatnot. And speaking of that, I have a funny announcement to make. You see, over Christmas, my family was nice enough to get me a present of a personal home computer, a decent gaming and rendering PC. And, well, judging by this recording, it can record just fine. So, yeah, you can expect more content of slightly higher quality now on. Basically, a lot of my past streams recently, when I tried to get back into streaming, they all kind of died from internet issues. And I theorize that that might be because my streaming laptop might just have a crappy Wi-Fi card, or it's like overheating or something. But now with a PC, that won't be an issue. So that means streams are going to be back in high gear, better than ever, and all that jazz. But also, I get a secondary PC to read chat and stuff, which will be great. Also, I can finally stream games that are very high quality. For instance, Pathologic Ch 2 has been on my gaming list for a long time now, and I'm very excited to stream it for you guys. Anyways, thank you for for sticking with me despite not uploading for almost half a year. Hopefully 2023 will be the year of the 10G content, and hopefully I'll get around to making some stuff. In fact, I feel like there's something you guys should probably see. You see, back in the past, I used to cancel a lot of video projects often whenever I couldn't finish them, i.e. the Pokemon Randomizer Nuzlocke and the timeline. Well, I'm happy to announce that in commemoration of myself finally leaving PixelArt, I decided to go back and I'm completing the timeline video. I went back and I did more research. I ended up making some more connections with people like Nanner and Quinn and Bedtime, who are all very, very well versed in the lore of PixelArt, and they kind of taught me some things about early PixelArt, and I want to share them with you guys. So, the timeline project is officially back in development. I'm not intending to use the work that people have made in the past without their permission, of course. I'm gonna go back and ask people like Dragon Key for permission to use their digital art again, because obviously, it's been years at this point. Who knows if they still want to be part of it? But I actually have done a decent amount of editing. I'm already on the 2017 portion, and it's only gonna get faster and more efficient from here on, especially with the Render Beast PC. Like, I can render the video in like 10 minutes now. So this is gonna be awesome. Anyways, here's a little clip just so that way you guys can see what's going on. Anyways, thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you when the timeline video or the Inclement Emerald Shiny Lock Part 3 comes out. Until then, I'll see you next time. Thanks for stopping by. See ya. The year was 2015, and pixel art was blasting off. Hundreds of new users were joining the website, and in turn brought hundreds and hundreds, maybe even thousands more. This was where the humble beginnings for a lot of the website's most legendary artists began. One in particular being Fleja. Fleja's humble beginnings as a pixel artist began here, from what we know. They were just a fan of Terraria who liked to create things, and create things they did. Fleja was a perfect example of what pixel art at this time was. A bunch of kids who were new to the idea of posting art online, creating and sharing things without any regard for how cringe or how cool it really was. Towards the end of 2015, thousands and thousands, if not tens of thousands of people started joining pixel art all at once. Pixel art had finally done it. They had finally landed the first page of the Google search for pixel art, and from then on, it would be a mainstay. One of these newer users who joined through the Google search terms was Nihilist. According to most 2015 to 2016 pixel art users, Nihilist was considered the best artist on the site. Not only were they humble about their art knowledge, they taught other people how to get better at artwork themselves. Using pixel art's animation features, they created animated tutorials that showed step-by-step instructions on how to improve at certain aspects of artwork. Some could argue that it was the seed Nihilist planted that slowly led to a revolution on pixelart.com. A revolution of quality, of improvement, of growing as an artist, and showing your journey all along the way through creating artwork. As 2016 rolls around, the pixel art search terms are off the charts. For the first time ever, it's climbing up slowly to the top of the page, usurping Pic in the process. With the sudden influx of new users, a bunch of future legendary artists started to join the site. People like Slinky, Vestar, Wolf, and numerous others started to show their face and improve on the website. By this point, Nihilist had left the website. In their absence, they left a wealth of knowledge for other artists to use and improve with. However, when Nihilist left, they didn't just leave knowledge for other people to become better. They left a position, a role model of sorts for art improvement, to stand in their place and help the next generation of pixel art users get better. And the person to take this mantle and become the next role model was none other than Fleja. They started grinding out artwork, refining their craft, and becoming a better artist. By the end of 2016, they were the undisputed king of pixelart.com. They studied pixel art technique and made dithering bend to their will. They studied color theory and made stunning palettes for all to use. And by the turn of 2017, they were widely considered one of the best pixel artists across the entire internet of all time. Fleja was not the only success story from pixel art in 2016, however. There was Kali Kimothy, there was Slinky, there was Vestar, and there were many more. And thanks to the newly implemented staff picks from late 2015, these artists and their great work were being featured front and center on the front page of the website. With the major drawing app overhaul halfway through 2016, it was only up from here for pixel art. Pic, though, was kind of in a slump. You see, it peaked all the way back in 2013, and since then had been in a downward spiral. Many of the top artists there were dropping Pic in favor of pixel art as their main drawing source. This was when many of Pic's artists' grievances with pixel art began to come to light. Either way, 2017 was going to be a crazy year for pixel art.